why is collaborative planning so important for the Inclusion and Wellbeing Service, do you think?
That's one of our big changes, hasn't it? Mm-hmm. I think we've kind of gone from being three discrete teams, something has been one big service.
Yeah.
How's that happened? One of the big ways has been the passport to success, probably, I think.
The passport's been a huge part of it, because I think obviously it started with the secondary team, but then became adapted for primary. And I know kind of for us, the school within Connolly, we adapted it and tweaked it so that it had everything in that one document that we needed. And it has the strategies, the strengths, interests, and a little bit of information about the child's individual health that needed to be kind of on the document too.
Yeah.
And I think that the information on that is key to every conversation we have when we're collaboratively planning for individual pupils. So, for example, whenever KTR teams become involved and work together for a child who's maybe had either a crisis with a high tariff incident or something's broken down within the family, and we need to get together and have a discussion about how to support the team. And I think whenever we are together, sitting around a table, and there's team from all parts of the service, and we bring all of that expertise together, I think it has such an impact on the outcomes for that pupil and what we can put together
that's
for them.
That's exactly the same for us, although within the mainstream setting it provides us a document that we can sit around together with the staff in the mainstream setting who's supporting that pupil, as well as members from our team, and we can really drill down into what are the things that are not successful for this pupil and what are the things that really are successful, and then we can tap into those and make sure that we're really focusing on that child's ability to succeed and how we're going to support that. And schools are finding the document very, very useful. And some schools are actually taking that on board themselves and starting to use it independently of us, which is fantastic, because that means that that capacity building within the mainstream school is coming, and it has come from the Inclusion and Wellbeing Service, which is great.
Absolutely.
I think as well the link for us too is with parents. Mm-hmm. So when parents are now coming in to have these passport meetings where the document's in front of them and it's just a conversation between them and the class teacher and the pupil, and they're looking at the document together and talking about the strategies that that pupil has come up with that they can use day to day within whatever environment they're in, whether it's within their mainstream setting or within Connolly School campus, and then that conversation brings so much to it, so that it's more lighthearted for the parent. They're kind of sitting having a chat about how their pupil's getting on, but also you find out so much about how they think, what they feel about the school as well, and it brings that collaborative work there as well, which is really useful. Do you find that in secondary too, Michael?
I do. I think it's there's something about it just telling a kid's story, in one really simple document. So it goes beyond school as well. If we think about our kind of big partnership planning event that we run throughout the year, where we talk about case studies almost to young people, but we invite along employers, train providers, other partners who we think might have a role to play in supporting each young person. There's something about that as a kind of as a stimulus for that discussion that's really important. A nice way to bring people together, I think, to find solutions.
Absolutely.
And off the back of that, we've developed the way that we are supporting our children across the service and having those discussions with staff from secondary, staff from Connolly, and staff from the early intervention team, and looking at these individual case studies around focused around that passport. So this is a pupil that's really in distress. We're really struggling to find out, we've tried lots of different approaches and still we're not being successful, but having all these heads together with all of this knowledge from previous experiences to suggest other pathways that we could take for that child, and then having a really tight time frame on looking at what that is going to look like for that child and reviewing that at the end. I think those the constant tracking of that and the successes within how that passport works, and then coming back and reviewing that. I know that staff have found that very, very beneficial, and that there's a lot of interventions that have happened as a result of that, because staff have been working and being able to go in and tap in to knowledge of other staff within the service in order to say, well, what do you think I could do about this? Have you tried this? What skills do you have that you could use to be able to support this child? Because I don't have those skills myself. And then and working together as a team has been really, really good.
I think as well having it on our calendar Yes. So we're doing it 3 times a year, yeah. And so staff know that that's there. And I think I'm looking forward to us getting together mm-hmm. for the next 2 sessions to see what the impact yeah. is that that yeah. brings for each pupil, and to see what interventions have been put in place. And then I would hope that that could then impact on other children, because mm-hmm. there may be things that are successful that we could then use absolutely. With other similar situations.
Yes. And really staff positive. Find it supportive too, having that network of people to be able absolutely. To discuss, so that they're not just working with the child on their own. And they have other people to go and discuss their difficulties and their positive success stories as well, yeah. which our staff are very good at sharing, which is really, really good mm-hmm. and nice to see. Mm-hmm.